Good morning everyone. How are you? Hope you are feeling fine. My dear students, today I will discuss a new topic, that is report writing. In today's lecture, I will try to discuss the format of a report. My dear students, there are many types of report, but you are to answer the questions on mainly newspaper report. So today I will focus on the ways of writing a news report or newspaper report. So my dear students, let's start.
Teacher, the three types of questions which are said in your question paper. First type is concerning accidents or incidents of loss caused by nature or humans. Second type is celebration of a day, organizing a program or a fair. And the last type is a particular incident, issue or topic. And today I will discuss the format which is fully applicable for the first type, and for the second type and third type, the body and conclusion may be somewhat different. So my dear students, let's continue. And here you find the format of a report, newspaper report or news report. In a news report, there will be a title or a heading, then the lead or the introduction, the body and conclusion. These are the four things which are included in a news report or newspaper report. First, let's talk about the title. Here you find some titles, and while writing a title, you should follow certain things. First thing is omission of article. We do not use article in a title, and here in these titles you do not find use of article. And another thing is that use of action verb. Here you find in all the titles action verbs have been used: loans, then passes, finds, picks, things, all these are action verbs. Next, in the titles, be verbs are avoided. The first title is economy on path to gradual recovery. Actually, be verb is omitted here. The sentence is economy is on path to gradual recovery, but here is, that is be verb has been omitted. Look at this title: NID cut for Jerry, EC officials compromising server security. Actually, the sentence is EC officials are compromising server security. So here the be verb are is omitted. Then in this title, we find longer tour not possible under SLC's conditions. So longer tour, actually the sentence is longer tour is not possible under SLC's conditions. So here the be verb is has been omitted. And another thing is abbreviations or short forms are used. Here DU, that is Dhaka University, DU, the short form has been used. Here NID, that is National Identity Card, NID, the abbreviation or short form has been used. And here BCB, Bangladesh Cricket Board, here the short form BCB has been used. So my dear students, while writing a title or a heading, you should follow these things. Use of action verb. You should use the action verbs. Omission of article. You should avoid using any article. That is, article is omitted. Abbreviations and short forms are used. You have to use abbreviation or short forms. Be verbs are avoided. We do not use be verb or be verbs in the headings. That is, be verbs are omitted. And sometimes subtitles are used. So while writing a title, you should keep in mind these things. Next, introduction to 3 W's. Before the lead or the introduction, we have to write something which we can express using 3 W's. First W means who. That is, the reporter, the name of the reporter or the designation of the reporter. Next, second W is where. Second W means where. That is, the place of reporting. And the last W means when. That is, the date of reporting. And here you find an example of 3 W's. Staff reporter, Rangpur, 16 September 2020. So, first W, staff reporter. Here the designation has been used. Then place of reporting, Rangpur, and the date of reporting, 16 September 2020. Now, lead or the introduction. While writing the lead or the introduction, you should try to seek answers to these 5 questions. What? What is the report about? Where? Where did the incident take place? When did it take place? Why did it take place? How or how much injury or loss did it cause? So, you should try to seek the answers of these 5 questions in the lead or the introduction. Here you find an example. A musk, here first the title, musk collapse kills 15 in Somalia. And the lead is, a musk under refurbishment has collapsed in Somalia, killing at least 15 people and injuring 40. It happened during Friday prayers as the building in the capital Mogadishu was packed with prayers. The lead or the introduction may consist of 1 sentence or 2 sentences. And here in the introduction we find 2 sentences. So what is the report about? A mosque collapse. Where did it happen? In Somalia. When did it happen? during Friday prayers. Why did it happen? Actually, we do not find any clear answer to these questions, but we find an indication that so many people were killed, as a lot of people were in the mosque at the time of prayers. And how much injury did it cause? How much injury did it cause? Actually, at least 15 people were killed and 40 people were injured. Here we find killing at least 15 people and injuring 40. And as the cause of the incident, we find as the building in the capital Mogadishu was packed with prayers. So many people were killed because the building in the capital Mogadishu was packed with worshippers. Now the body. In the body, we will describe the main incidents. Then statement of the persons concerned. You can describe the statement of the persons concerned. Statement of the eyewitnesses. You can describe the statement. You can mention the statement of the eyewitnesses. And you must avoid the use of first person. In the newspaper report or news report, the reporter will not give any opinion. The reporter will not express his or her own opinion. So you will avoid the use of first person I, because you will not express your own opinion. You will not say I think, I suppose. This way you will not make any comment. You will not give your opinion. Here you find an example. Some media outlets report. We find the statement of the media outlets. The state-owned Somali national news agency said. Here we find another news agency making its opinion or comment. And here you find another example. Witnesses said. We find the statement of the witnesses. Then Mannan Sheikh, the subconductor of the work, said. Here we find the statement of a person concerned, the subconductor. So my dear students, in the body, you can describe these things. You will describe the main incidents. You will describe the statement of the persons concerned. You will mention the statement of the eyewitnesses. And you will not use first person I, because you will yourself not make any comment. You yourself will not make any comment. Now the conclusion. In the conclusion, there will be the statement of the responsible authorities concerning probe or treatment, statement of the responsible authorities concerning compensation, and offering condolence and sympathy. Here you find an example. This report is about the Nimtoli tragedy. And Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina quickly rushed to the spot, cancelling all official programs, and spent a whole sleepless night personally supervising the rescue operation and medical care of the wounded survivors. The Prime Minister made certain that the fire victims got the best possible treatment in hospitals and clinics at state cost. She ensured that the related government agencies came forward wholeheartedly and helped the victims in every possible manners. And here you find another example. Meanwhile, the Industries Ministry and the Fire Service and Civil Defense formed separate committees to probe the fire. Police last night filed a case against unidentified traders on charges of causing the death of 67 through negligence. So, you find the statement of the responsible authorities concerning probe and treatment. You also find the statement of the responsible authorities concerning compensation. And sometimes condolence and sympathy is offered. So, my dear students, in a report, you should write a heading or title. You should write the lead of the introduction consisting of one sentence or two sentences. You should write a body where you will describe the main incident. You will describe the statement of the responsible, the statement of the persons concerned. You can also avoid the use of first person because you yourself cannot make any comment. You cannot give your opinion. And in conclusion, you can state the response, state the, you can write the statement of the responsible authorities concerning probe and treatment and also compensation. Condolence or sympathy sometimes is offered from the side of responsible authorities, and you can also mention that. So, my dear students, you can write a report considering all these things. You can write a report keeping all these things in your mind. That's all today. Thank you. Thank you very much.